Hey everyone, welcome to the second video on developing applications for the Flipper Zero using scenes. In the previous video, we talked about the scene manager for Flipper Zero and the advantages and disadvantages. I highly recommend you watch that video first, as it provides background information that this video is building on. In this video, we're going to cover application concepts in detail and then look at some of the demo project code that starts to implement those concepts. I'll release a third video next Thursday where we deep dive into the code. The next two slides cover concepts we need to know to build an application. Our application has application data. In our example, we had a volume and frequency. And then it has components. And in our example, we used a widget and a knob. Each component has a view, and the view has different properties. Typically, it has a model, which is the data that's associated with the view. And then it has a method to invoke for drawing on the canvas. When that method gets invoked, you get passed the model with all of your data. And then it has a method to invoke for processing input events. And in that case, the context that gets passed to you is this component. If you need to change the model while you're processing input events, there's a with view model construct where you can pass in the context and then your code. And it will edit the model's data. And if the model has any guards, it will acquire and release the mutex guards as well. Typically, in your input events code, you'll do some special callback when you think that the application hosting your component would like to know about it. For example, when the OK button is clicked in our knob, we invoke a callback. The view dispatcher is told about each of the views of our components. And it's given an ID that we'll use to refer to those views. Finally, the scene manager has a list of our scene objects. And each scene object has an onEnter method that gets invoked when we enter the scene, an onEvent method for events during our scene, and an onExit method as we exit the scene. The scene manager also has the application context, and it handles our navigation. When the scene manager calls our onEnter, we're going to go ahead and configure the component that our scene needs. So if it's a widget or a knob, we're going to set the configuration and its state. And then we're also going to configure a callback method that we want to get invoked when interesting thing happens, like when the OK button is pressed. When our callback gets invoked, the callback will tell the view dispatcher about a custom event. And then that custom event will end up invoking our onEvent method. In our onEvent method, we'll handle those custom events, typically either changing the application state or perhaps telling the scene manager there's a different scene we want to transition to. Finally, our onExit does any component cleanup, for example, releasing any resources that were allocated during the onEnter. Okay, the next few slides are going to show the code that implements these concepts. So in our demo application, we had three scenes, the set volume, the set frequency, and the summary scene. And we're going to define an enum with those scene names. And that'll have a value of 0, 1, and 2. And then scene num will be 3, which happens to be how many scenes we have. Next, we define an enum with our components. The order of these are not important. And in this case, we're having a knob component and a widget component. Then for each scene, we're going to implement 3 handler callbacks. So we're going to have the app scene summary on enter, a summary on event, and a summary on exit. And we're also going to have a volume on enter, volume on event, volume on exit, and a frequency on enter, frequency on event, and frequency exit. Next, we're going to create a list of those handlers. So we're going to have all our enter handlers, all of our event handlers, and all of our exit handlers. And the order of these need to match the order in which we created our enum. So volume, frequency, summary. And then finally, we're going to create a scene manager handler, and we're going to set the enter handlers, the event handlers, the exit handlers, and the number of scenes. Then for our application, we're going to create a structure to hold our scene manager, our view dispatcher, our knob, and our widget, and then our application data of volume and frequency. All right, so hopefully that's given you some understanding of scenes in the scene manager. And in the next talk, we're going to go into details on how we allocate the data, our callbacks, our application entry point, what's inside those on enter, on event, and on exit routines, and then how we do freeing of resources. I hope you found this information helpful. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below.